Plexus is a system in which you can take super cheap materials, in this case PVC, and build infinitely customizable simple things like shelves. The cool part about it is PVC is a very, very cheap and strong material. A 10-foot section of 1-inch PVC is somewhere around $4. So you can take this super cheap material, connect it very easily, and make really cool stuff. So let me show you how Plexus works. The first thing I want to show you is, in this video, I'm just going to show you the two most basic Plexus models. This is what I call the snap corner, and this is called the crossbar. Now, I have tons of models at this point, but I don't want to confuse you because there's lots of different accessories, hooks, things like that. These are for 1-inch PVC pipe, and I've got them for 1/2-inch PVC pipe, those types of things. But for this video, I just want to concentrate on the two simplest models, and that is the snap corner and the crossbar. First up is the crossbar. And the crossbar is, you know, fairly simple. All it does is it slides onto one piece and it holds another piece across, hence the name crossbar. And the cool part about it is as you slide one piece on, it actually tightens the other piece. So this is really cool. But of course, it has a hole in it. So if you need to lock it down, you can screw into it. And I'll show you that in a second. Next up is the snap corner. And the reason I actually call it the snap corner is when you build stuff out of PVC, one of the most frustrating things is to always have to slide it on. So once you build a model, if you screwed something up and it's already put together, having to take the whole thing apart to put on a new piece can be super frustrating. Well, the cool part about the snap corner is it'll actually snap on to an already built model, or you can slide it on. It's up to you. The snap corner is pretty self-explanatory, but what it enables you to do is build corners of rectangles and cubes. When building Plexus models and I need those pieces to fit tight, I usually screw them in. Now, I didn't want a bunch of steps, so like having to drill a pilot hole and then screw a screw in, those types of things. So what I found out is that self-tapping screws, which just mean that they have that little drill bit on the end, are absolutely awesome for PVC and they hold super tight. The best place to find self-tapping screws is in the sheet metal screws. So this is what a sheet metal screw looks like, and I believe this is a number 10. The width is not that critical, and the length is not that critical, because if you look, it doesn't need to go that far in and then to go into the PVC. So you don't need it to be super long. These are just the ones I had on hand right now. As far as a screwdriver goes, you can do these by hand. Obviously, that would take a while, but you don't necessarily need a drill. I love these small powered screwdrivers, and they have plenty enough power for pushing these self-tapping screws through the plastic pieces and then into the PVC. These screws go in surprisingly easy. All I do is I use the hole to line it up, and then I push it as it goes through into the PVC, and then it locks itself down as it pulls the threads into the PVC. No need to really do it any tighter than that. Really, what you're getting out of the screw being in there is it keeps the piece from sliding up and down your main vertical piece. This is where it gets really cool. The concept here is that you can make things as customizable as you can imagine, as creative as you want. The coolest part is the dimensions. You can cut the PVC pieces to any dimensions that you actually need. So I had about 1.5 feet of space right here that was not being utilized at all. And I was like, hey, what a great place to put my running gear. I can put some shelves here for my running shoes, and then I can put hang up some of my rain jackets and things like that that I use very often here where it rains a lot. The cool part is I can use for the shelves just whatever scraps I have around, and I'm gonna show you how to make shelves in one of an upcoming video. You can either make them out of cardboard by layering and gluing some cardboard together, or you can use some traditional materials. I just had some scrap plywood around, so I just cut it to the right dimensions, and then I cut the corners out 2.5 inches in, 2.5 inches in, and then across. And what that gave me is these shelves that fit perfectly inside, and they slide right up against the edge pieces, and it works great. So this model in particular is super simple. All it is 12 corner pieces and then just 2 crossbars, and then a crossbar obviously in the middle. And then that would make it 4, 4, 4 1 foot sections, and then 4 5 foot sections. And PVC pipe usually comes in 10 foot sections. So that's why I think this model is a great one to start out with, because it's super simple. Just get 4, or you know, get 2 10 foot sections to make the vertical pieces. And then all you really need is 2 more for the pieces, the horizontal pieces. So you need 12 of those as well. So a super simple model, really cool place to start. Or you could just get a little bit more PVC, a few more corner pieces, and you could just build this shelf as high as you needed it. Last but not least, I want to talk about what's coming up next. I love this project. Believe it or not, I've been working on it for a long time. And there's so many different things that you can do, especially from this point. So I just wanted to show you some of the stuff that, you know, to give you an idea of how cool this project can expand into. Of course, you can add hooks, you can add all sorts of things to your normal models right now for hanging up stuff and for storing gear. That's what what Plexus is really, really good at. What's cool though is once you start using smaller pieces of PVC, you can start building little things like stands. Like this is a really cool model I was working on for a stand for something. I've been working on some really cool concepts for corners. And one of my favorite concepts is just simply a little triangle piece, and you need to build this out of some flexible 3D printed material, and ABS works pretty good for this piece. And then the cool part about it is once you put this together, then you can start building your corners with a flexible piece of plastic that doesn't take up nearly as much plastic as well. This I'm still developing. The problem I'm having right now is it works great with 1/2 inch PVC. As soon as I scale this up, this plastic tends to crack, especially when you start building it bigger. And that's just a design flaw I'm still working on. And I need some more durable plastic and trying to figure out different ways of doing it. The problem is as I get more durable plastic, it tends to flex too much. And then my model is all wobbly. So there are some issues I'm still working through, and some really cool stuff on the horizon. So one last thing I want to tell you about, and the reason more people haven't done this, and I've solved this problem, and it's coming up in a very next video, probably not the next video, but it's definitely coming up very quickly. The problem is when people build stuff out of PVC, PVC pipe still flexes a little bit. So you get this lateral flexage, you get a little bit of a twist flexage to it, and it drives people crazy and they go, it sounds great when you start to build it. And then as soon as you build it, you're like, oh, it's not stable enough to actually make shelves and things out of. Well, I've solved that problem, and I'm going to show you in a coming video how to solve the flex issue. The simple answer is, if you build something for storage and you just like all the cheap shelves and stuff you can get in furniture, you can get at IKEA, they usually put a back plate on it. That actually makes it super stable. So you could actually take that cork board or those pegboard type materials and just build a back plate and then just screw that in. That would make it super stable. The models that are actually available to download for free right now, they have holes in the ends. And I did that specifically, they have holes right here. I don't have them on these, but the ones that you download do. They have holes right here. And the reason is you can take 550 cord and you can run it through those holes, tie a knot, and then you can cross brace your shelves or your storage unit. and it'll be super stable because 550 cord does not flex that much at all. So if you tighten down that 550 cord, then tie a knot in it and you create some cross braces, it works awesome and it also looks really cool too. So I'm gonna show you that in an upcoming video. I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope you're as excited about Plexus as I am and where we're going with it. Let me tell you that I'm excited to bring it to you for free, and eventually I'm gonna have like a pro kit that you could download for super cheap. But the reason is because I wanna be able to lump all the models together for somebody that wants like the whole library and they can download it all at once. I want to be able to do that as well. But most of the common pieces, I always want them to be free because I want you guys to build cool stuff and learn that this is a really, really cool idea. And I want you guys to expound on it and have fun and keep developing for it as well. I'd love it for it to be an open project. So I really appreciate it. I hope you enjoy this video. If you've got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandoDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.